Hi, this is Elizabeth Postel from BorisFX. In this quick tip video, I'll show how to transfer your custom keyboard shortcuts between different versions of Mocha, or even different workstations. Knowing the shortcuts can make a huge improvement in your work speed, but sometimes you may want to customize that keys so that they will work even better for your needs. It's very easy to tweak them in Mocha. You just need to go to File, Keyboard, and choose Customize. Now you need to duplicate the default preset and give it a new name. Let's sum up a few to give you an example. As for me, I prefer to have all my important buttons on the left side of the keyboard, so I can easily access them without moving my hand too much. In Roto and Paint work, we often need to go frame by frame, so I find it handy to have navigation buttons right on the tips of my fingers. I like to remap next frame to letter S and previous frame to letter A. It's easy to use Filter to find the right action. Select the needed action in the list, hit Clear, and enter a new preferred key. Make sure that you don't choose keys that are already attached to another action. If they do, you either need to choose another key or to simply clear the default one that you won't be using. Now I will repeat the same process for the previous frame shortcut. Find it with a filter, clear the old key, assign the new one, and delete the default intersecting command. Otherwise, it won't work correctly. Hit OK and you're done. Now I can easily move frame by frame and not move my left hand at all. But what if you're an artist who constantly jumps between different hosts or uses standalone from time to time? You definitely wouldn't want to set up that for every version of Mocha manually. The easiest way to share that preset would be to copy the keyboard preference file and put it in the right place, so every version of Mocha would find that. Here are the paths you need to follow for Windows, Mac, and Linux. You can also find them in the description below. I'm now on a Windows machine, so I will follow the corresponding path. Here you'll find few Mocha folders depending on what you have installed. I created my preset with OFX plugin, so I need to go inside the plugin folder. And here is the preset file I just created. Now I can copy that file hitting Ctrl+C or Command+C on a Mac, go back and paste that file in other Mocha folders. Now if I open Mocha AE or standalone, I will see my preset in the presets list. You can also save that file anywhere on your hard drive for a backup or share it with another artist. I prefer to save all my preference files on a small USB flash drive, which I carry with me. So if I need to work on another workstation, I have almost all my savings with me. And this was my quick tip for Mocha. I hope I sparked an idea for you about how you can create your custom preset that will work best for you. If you want more of these quick tips, subscribe to the BorisFX YouTube channel or visit forum borisfx.com if you have any questions. See you next time. Bye.